I'm Joshua Bardwell, and you're going to learn something today. Hello, beginners. This is a video for beginners to FPV and to quadcopters, because what we're going to talk about in this video is props and how to know that you're putting your props on correctly. So if you already know how to do that, I'll see you tomorrow. Let's start by talking about the anatomy of a prop. The first thing you want to do when you look at a prop is identify the top and the bottom side. And this will become second nature with just a little bit of time. But if the prop has any lettering on it, the lettering will be on the top side of the prop. So you can see this prop is embossed master air screw, and it's also embossed 3B 13 by 8.0R. These letters on top indicate that this is the top of the prop. If we look on the bottom, we can see there's no markings or letterings. And I've got a couple other examples of props here. This is an Emax prop, and it's marked. It has no lettering on the blades themselves, but it's marked here on the hub, Avon, and some other numbers, whereas there's nothing on the underside. Here's a gem fan prop. Here we go. We got a marking here on top. And here is a very, very teeny, teeny prop. I don't even know who makes this, but yes, even on this teeny little prop, there is GF, gem fan. This is a gem fan prop. Even on this tiny prop, there's a little bit of lettering. And you can see that if we look at it from the underside, it's backwards. So clearly, this is the top. And just because I don't want anybody to feel left out, here are some ethics props. These are Mr. Steele's props. They're made by HQ. Also makes very good props. And sure enough, if we look right here, there we go. It's marked, what does it say? HQ prop. There we go. And it's probably marked with the size Ethics S4. Okay, so that's the top. Once you've identified the top of the prop, the next thing you'll do is identify the leading and the trailing edge. And the leading edge of the prop is going to be high, and the trailing edge of the prop is going to be low. And if you think about it, the reason for that is that as the prop spins, it's going to push air downwards, and due to something called conservation of momentum, that will result in the quadcopter being pushed upwards, and the quadcopter will fly. So the leading edge is high, the trailing edge is low. Here is the leading edge, and here is the trailing edge. High and low. And here, even on this little teeny, teeny, tiny prop, we can see that that is true. If we look at it, look at it edge on, here's the leading edge, and here's the trailing edge. And we can see that, let's look at this gem fan prop here. So we've got the leading edge here and the trailing edge here. As you look at more and more props, you'll start to recognize the shape. For example, if the prop has this little bulbous part here at the hub, that's the trailing edge. That's just how they're always designed. But not all props are going to have that. So this Ethics S4 prop here, we've got a leading edge here. It's a little bulbous. And then the trailing edge is a little flatter. So you just look at the high and the low, and that tells you what the leading and the trailing edge is. Now, when you've identified the top and bottom and leading and trailing edge of the prop, that will tell you which way the prop is intended to spin. A lot of times, people might look for CW clockwise or CCW counterclockwise marked on the prop, or reverse or standard direction. Don't worry about that. You can just look at it. We can just see that this prop, this is the top, and here's the leading edge. The prop will always spin towards the leading edge. So this prop is intended to spin this direction. It is a clockwise prop. Here we got another prop. It'll spin towards the leading edge. It's a counterclockwise prop. It's easy, see? This guy, a little hard to see the leading edge because it's so tiny, but yeah, this is a clockwise prop. This is a counterclockwise prop. Here's the leading edge, spins toward the leading edge. And this guy here is a clockwise prop. Now, probably what you're doing is you're putting the props on your quadcopter, and so you need to know how this all comes together. And in order to do that, you need to know which direction your quadcopter's motors rotate. If you're not sure, take your props off, arm the quad with the props off, and just take a little piece of paper or something and touch it against the motor and see which way the motor pushes. And you should see that the motors rotate either props in, which means that the motors rotate towards the center line. Hang on, get off of there, you. Rotate either props in, which means they're rotating toward the center line, or props out, which means they're rotating away from the center line. Now, on a quadcopter, it is always true that the two diagonal motors spin the same direction. Why is that? Don't worry about it. So the two diagonal motors are always going to spin the same direction, which means that if the front motors are going props in, the rear motors are also going props in toward the center line of the quad. And if the front motors are going props out, the rear motors must also be going props out. So that's very convenient for us. It will never be the case that these motors are going props in and these rear motors are going props out. If that were the case, the quadcopter wouldn't fly. If you accidentally do that and you try to fly, your quadcopter will flip out. So what we got to do is we got to identify the motor direction, and it's very handy if you just build all your quads to have the same motor direction. And if you're wondering which motor direction is best, props in or props out, I have a video about that, and it's linked down in the video description if you want to watch that after you finish this one. So this quadcopter is set up for props in, and what that means is that when we identify the leading edge needs to be going towards the center line. So this quad here, leading edge is here. We're going to put that on this front motor so that it spins toward the center line. This quad, this prop here, okay, I can put that either here or I can put that here. Either way, the leading edge of the prop is going toward the center line because the motors are spinning props in. And likewise, here, this guy here, oh, no. Look at the leading edge. That is props out. That's not how this quad is set up. And in fact, a nice shortcut for you is that you will always have the same prop on diagonal motors as well. Since the motors are spinning the same direction, they'll also have the same prop. So this prop here is the same as this prop here. It's going to go on this diagonal motor and spin props in. And that leaves us with this guy here. Don't assume just because you have four props that they're all the four correct props. If you just opened a fresh bag of props, then yes, you'll have two clockwise and two counterclockwise. But if you made your own bag of props, you could have grabbed the wrong one. So double check. And in fact, now we can do a final check. And I do this check every time I change a prop. The first time I set the quad down, I just real quick eyeball it. And what I can see is that leading edge moving in, good. And on the rear, we've got leading edge. If you don't get that right, the quad will flip out when you try to fly, it'll be bad. Okay, there you go. That is a quick primer on props and prop direction, how to tell prop direction and how to install the props correctly on the motor. And all, you know, hey beginners, a lot of folks leave this out. In fact, I made this video because I was doing a setup video for this quadcopter, and I put that information in the setup video, but I thought, a lot of you guys didn't buy this quadcopter, and you're not going to watch that video. So here it is, the information you need in a video all by itself. Thank you so much for watching. And if you're new to the channel and you're a beginner, welcome to the channel. My goal is to help beginners like you get over. There's so much to learn in this hobby, isn't there? And you feel totally overwhelmed and you're like, what am I going to do? Well, my goal is to try and help you get over that and get to the point where you feel like you know a thing or two. And so hopefully after this video, you're one step closer, and hopefully you'll watch a whole bunch more of my videos or maybe even subscribe to my channel. And you know, I'll see you in the comments. Thanks for watching. Happy flying.